ध्याने परित्यज्य क्रमाध्येयैकगोचरम् निवात दीपवत् चित्तं समाधिरभिधीयते प्रॉपर श्रवण मनन वन हैज टू टेक टू निधिध्यासन The purpose of Vididhyasana is to get freed from the habitual error, Viparita Bhavana. In spite of knowing what I am in reality, the identification with the body still continues. So to get rid of them, get rid of that identification, one has to take to Vididhyasana. One thing to be clear, knowledge is gained only in Shravana. Don't think Vididhyasana gives the knowledge. Vididhyasana is repeated, not assertion, the redwelling on the knowledge already gained in the Shravana, which has been clarified in the Manana. So Manana taken to find, that means understand the suitability, the tenability of the knowledge gained through the Shruti Vichara as given to reasoning, Shruti Sammata Tarka. So then, at least again some doubts also may be there. Vagueness and doubt is clarified in the Manana. Afterwards, dwelling on that knowledge, to get rid of the habitual error, that is what is the job of the Vididhyasana. For effective Vididhyasana, certainly the clarity in the knowledge, the Shravana, in terms of gaining the knowledge is essential. So here, one may ask, when I am to take to Vididhyasana, or is it necessary to take to Vididhyasana? You have to decide. If you don't have Deha Tadatmya, there is no necessity of Nididhyasana at all. If you are the Uttamottam Adhikari, there are only few, like Vasishtha Vamadeva somewhere, where, here and there may be there. Or if like that, there is no necessity of Nididhyasana because the Deha Tadatmya will not be there. Then the knowledge itself, everything is clear. If it is not so, Nididhyasana is a must. Because most of the seekers belong to rest of the category. Uttam Adhikaris are very rare. Don't join the delusion that I am a Uttam Adhikari. They are very, very rare as such. Because we belong to the rest of the category. So Nididhyasana is required. Other point is that demarcation. When I have to take Nididhyasana, see, such demarcations are not possible in Vedanta. For example, to take to Shravana, what is necessary? Not take to Shravana, to take to effective Shravana or to get the real benefit of Shravana, what all things are essential? Sadhana Chatushtaya, Sampatti, Antatkarana, Siddhi. Is it right? Means, without Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti, without the Antatkarana Siddhi, Shravana will not be effective. So therefore, before taking to Shravana, I have to take to Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti or Karma Yoga and also coupled with the Karma Yoga so that I can gain the Antakarana Siddhi. But my mind asks me, why should I take to Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampatti? Why should I have Viveka? Why should I have Vairagya? What answer will you give? My mind is not ready to have Vairagya. You see, look, the objects of the world are so fascinating. Why you want to give them up? Why not enjoy them? The mind is asking and at times it may revolt also. So it has to be convinced about the defective nature of the world and also what the person is in for in terms of knowledge. Means what is the final goal? Means some idea about the final goal is necessary. How can we have the idea about the final goal unless some unfoldment about the Atma, about the Brahma at least to begin with is done? So therefore, to have that intensity of Viveka Vairaga, I should know what the final goal is. And to know what the final goal is, I have to have the Viveka Vairagya, which is the first step and which is the last step now. As per Shastra, Shravana, Manana, Vididhyasana, Samadhi. Okay? So therefore, first, and so before Shravana, I have to take to साधक विषय संपत्ति, बट टू हैव टू टेक टू साधक विषय संपत्ति आई शुड बी कन्विंस्ड अबाउट द गोल फॉर विच आई शुड हैव सम अंडरस्टैंडिंग अबाउट द गोल विच आई हैव टू एक्सपोज टू श्रवण ओनली. देयरफॉर इन वेदांत देयर इज नो फर्स्ट स्टेप एंड द लास्ट स्टेप, देयर इज नो स्टेप एट ऑल एंड येट वी हैव टू गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप ओनली. I think Swami Deva sir told you this. First step is the last step and the last step is the first step. There is no step and you have to go by step only. So that is what Vedanta is. So this was serious. Where are you going to start? But likewise, if that is the case with Shravana, here, Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, so for effective Nididhyasana, what should be there? Clarity of knowledge in the Shravana must be there. Otherwise, it will not be useful lesson. But how am I to know that it is such a total clarity is there? Up to here, clarity is there. Now onwards, you can take to Nididhyasana. Such a demarcating line is not available because it is a subjective thing as well. So what you have to do, it is just like swimming. It is just like cycling. For swimming, you have to plunge in the water. To plunge in the water, you should know first swimming, is it not? Will you dare to plunge in the water without knowing how to swim? Yet, and can you swim without plunging in the water? Therefore, what you have to do? Plunge in the water, practice, take strokes to begin with, gulp down little water inside also. So, if that is not there, then what you do? Tie up some inflating thing so that you will have some buoyancy effect and you will not sink all of a sudden. Like that. So, like guru, etc., are like, no, like tires, etc., you tie up your waist and jump in the water, like that being the case. To take to Nididhyasana, the clarity of knowledge must be there. But I don't know whether totally clear or not, but some understanding is there. So therefore, what? Take a plunge. Maybe Nididhyasana is not successful, but is there any harm? Is there any loss? At least one thing will be sure, by taking to that, you will have the peaceful mind, a command over a peaceful state of the mind, a mind that can enjoy the silence. Maybe Nididhyasana may not be highly effective, but that state of mind where some silence is there, some peace is there, cannot be denied. Is it not useful? It will be highly useful for further progress of the individual. So therefore, so we have to take Saknis, take the plan. There is no demarcating line as Shravana, Manana, and then afterwards everything is over. To take to Nididhyasana cannot be said so. So that will be take to that. It will be certainly helpful. And Nididhyasana is a must so long as the identification of the body is there. Otherwise, what will happen? A person like carrying the donkey carrying the gold or the load of sandalwood. That means it is not able to enjoy the fragrance of that. It is not knowing the worth of the gold that is carrying. You know that example Swamiji is giving? The born beggar example. The born beggar, who is now multi-billionaire now, still has not assimilated the wealth. And his behavior betrays that still he is a beggar. That is our problem. In spite of gaining the knowledge, supposing that you have got the knowledge, in spite of gaining the knowledge, of course you are bound to get, don't think that it is not that difficult. But this is Shraddha. First, before everything, Viveka Vairagya must be thorough. If some interest is elsewhere and pulls are elsewhere, then everything is a doldrum. So that must be thorough. Then Shraddha, etc., it is not something difficult to do. Anyway, so when the knowledge is clear, and that means he can take to this in the sense, it will help you mutually yourself, and you can't say, here only I will take, afterwards, up to this point, I have to take the Shravana Manana, and afterwards I have to take Nididhyasana, but you can't divide like that at all. That means, and again somebody asked, Nididhyasana is not required, yes, not required, provided you don't have the Deha Tadati. Just as the beggar, born beggar, has to assimilate the wealth. I am not the beggar, I am the multi-billionaire. Feel that he has to do the contemplation that he is not the beggar. So also here it is necessary. Now, a particular question is here. Look, you have told us that some Nididhyasana is ekatanatva of the nirvichikitsartha. What is the artha? Jiva Brahma. The appreciation of the identity of Jiva and Brahma. That is the preoccupation given to the mind continuously to the exclusion of all other dissimilar thoughts. That is what is the Nididhyasana. It was told as Ekatanatvam. Ekatanatvam means Ekakara Vritti Pravahatvam. Continuous flow of one preoccupation, and that preoccupation is appreciation of the knowledge of the identity of Jiva and Brahma. Jiveshwaraika Jiva Dhamma Ikka. Now, if this is what is required, and that leads to Samadhi. Look here, efforts are necessary up to the point of Nididhyasana. Thereafter, what you have to do is to, you have to take to Nididhyasana. Nididhyasana fructifies in terms of Samadhi. Of your own volition, you can't do anything to take to Nididhyasana, because in, not Nididhyasana, Samadhi. Because in Samadhi, Dhyata, Dhyana, these are not there. What is there is only Dheyaika Gocharam. That thought, that vritti, that preoccupation is only about Dheyaika. Dheya is the Brahma. Eka Gocharam means only one Vishaya of Dheya alone is there for the mind. That is what is told as the Samadhi. Now look, to have this state of Dheyaika Gocharam, where there is Ekatanatva is there, constant flow of that one vritti which appreciates my real nature as not different from Brahma, Vivaika Brahma. So that should be there. Now, to have that, is it not necessary? So that means that is is it not necessary to have the Antakarna vritti? Antakarna vritti is there. But in Samadhi, Antakarna vritti is not cognized. Without Antakarna vritti, how can you say such a Samadhi is possible? That is what the If vrittis are not available in Samadhi, there is no possibility of Dhyayika Gocharatva. And if Dhyayika Gocharatva is not there, there is no possibility of the Samadhi. How are you going to explain this? Or you can say, what is the difference between these three states and the Samadhi? That also point out that in the Samadhi, Antakarana is present, though directly not cognized. What type of antakarana and what you will see from the sandhya.
Vrittaya stutadani madhyata apyatma gocharaha. Paranadanumiyante vitthitasya samutthitat. आत्मगोचराः वृत्तयः तु तदानीम् अज्ञाताः अपि व्युत्थितस्य समुत्थितात् स्मरणाद् अनुमीयन्ते.
At the time of samadhi, though antakarana atmagocharaha vritti, the vritti which reveals me the nature of atma. What is that vritti? Akhandakara vritti. Though directly not appreciated, means though overtly not cognized, though evidently not cognized, it is that these vrittis are there. What vrittis? Atmaika gocharaha. Atma gocharaha. Tadani, let us see. Atma gocharaha vrittayaha. What is atma gocharaha vrittayaha? Atma gocharaha vishayaha yasam taha. Atma is the gochara. Gochara means vishaya. Means atma is the object for which vritti. Atma gocharaha. Gochara means vishayaha. Yasam. Yasam vritti nam. For which vritti? Atma alone is the object of appreciation. So, there are those vrittis. This atma gocharaha vritti. Now again we have to see. Atma gocharaha vritti means generally a knowledge of vishaya is gained in terms of vishayakara vritti. Atma knowledge. What is the akara of atma? We have seen other day. Just yesterday we have seen. The formless it is. That's why you have to say by purity akhanda akara vritti. That for the akara means there is no limitations for that. Akhanda. So free from any akhanda limitation. Akhanda akara vritti. That is what is akhanda akara vritti. This is atma gocharaha vrittayaha tu. He means in contrast to the nididhyasana. In nididhyasana, akhandakara vritti, I am deliberately, with conscious effort, I am trying to bring it. Effort is there. Me, the contemplator, is bringing the vritti which can appreciate my real nature. With deliberate effort is there, and that vritti is positively cognized.
He says, in contrast to that,
Atmagocharaha vrittayaha tadanim. Tadanim at that time means at the samadhi kale, during the samadhi, adhnyataha api.
Adhnyata api means
even though not known. Not known means evidently not cognized.
That means overtly not cognized.
Adhnyataha api.
They are verily there.
Adhnyataha api. So, smaranad anumiyante.
Because of recollection. When recollection? When? After getting up from samadhi.
Means after getting up samadhi means what? In samadhi, he is not aware of even the body.
Not leave alone the world.
If he is aware of the body, what will happen? Savikalpa. Savikalpa, it is no more nirvikalpa.
It is no more nirvikalpa.
Even if I am not, this is, I am contemplating. Dhyata is there. Savikalpa, no more nirvikalpa. So therefore, that is not the case here. We are talking of nirvikalpa samadhi. Even the dhyata and dhyana is not there. What is there is only dhyayaka, gocharatvam is there. So smaranat anumiyanti means getting up means when now he has come to the, that means he has become aware of the body or aware of the world. Then what does he recollect?
Oh,
for a certain period of time, I was absorbed in nirvikalpa samadhi. Is it his experience or it is a memory?
Memory.
If he is experiencing his nirvikalpa samadhi, he is not aware of anything as such. Oh, I was in the samadhi for a certain period of time. I can't make out how long it was, but I was in that absorbed state of the samadhi. So therefore, smaranat anumiyante, they are inferred. If they are inferred, it is inferred by the smarana, recollection, is it not that earlier it was, anubhava was there? Where did you find it out?
Fifth chanda, it was there. See, what that is, yeah, here also it says,
sa smritihi avabuddha vishaya.
Sa.
Sa means, sausukta tamaha, tamatamatamata, tamobodaha.
Sa smritihi.
In the sleep, I did not anything as such. It is smriti. Why? And being a smriti, avabuddha vishaya.
It must have been naturally experienced earlier, which has been dealt in detail earlier in the fifth stanza, which otherwise you can take this vyapti.
Yadyat smaryate tattat anubhutam. Whatever that is smaryate, recollected, that should necessarily be the anubhutam, which is earlier
experience.
Because without experience, you can't have the recollection. Memory is not possible.
So therefore,
smaranat. But when it is smaranat, vitsitasya samutthitat smaranat.
Vitsitasya,
for the person, with that means samadhehe utthitasya.
Vitsitasya means samadhe utthitasya.
One who has come out of the samadhi. This samadhi, okay, we are not talking about yoga, Patanjali yoga samadhi, we are not talking about. We are talking of this samadhi, but where?
Dhyayika gocharan.
What is the dhyaya?
Brahma.
Brahma is a dhyaya. That vritti is there. So, anumiyante vichitasya means in the case of the person who has come out of this samadhi, samutthitat smaranat. By the smarana, by the memory, samutthitat. Samutthitat means utpannat. After coming out of the samadhi, whatever that recollection is there, oh, I was in the state of absorption. I was in the state of samadhi. That utthitat, samutthitat means utpannat. Whatever the memory is born, recollection is born from that anumiyante. What are anumiyante? What are inferred?
That
atmagocharaha vrittayaha were there earlier, were experienced earlier.
Here we have to see one thing.
The job of akhandakara vritti is to destroy
ajnana vritti.
Is to destroy the ignorance vritti. And when it is destroyed, as it appears, it coalesces as it were. Ajnana vritti goes, and for that means for outward appearance, it appears as though akhandakara vritti also is no more there.
That's what is told in Atmabodha.
Ajnana kalusham jivam jnanabhyasad vinirmalam krutva jnanam swayam nashe jalam katakarenu. Ajnana kalusham jivam.
This jiva, who is muddled as it were, polluted as it were, means who is in the state of samsari now,
on account of what? Ajnana. Ajnana kalusham jivam
ज्ञानाभ्यासाद विनिर्मलम कृत्वा, हैविंग मेड हिम टोटली प्योर, यू मीन हैविंग डिस्ट्रॉयड इग्नोरेंस बाय व्हाट? ज्ञानाभ्यास. व्हाट इज द ज्ञानाभ्यास? दैट इज व्हाट इज द रिपीटेशन ऑफ द अखंडाकार वृत्ति. ज्ञान स्टैंड फॉर द अखंडाकार वृत्ति विच इज बॉर्न वेयर श्रवण एंड मेड थॉरो इन द मदन. सो दैट अभ्यास ज्ञानाभ्यास विनिर्मलम कृत्वा, हैविंग मेड हिम प्यूरिफाइड मीन्स हैविंग प्यूरिफाइड मीन्स हैविंग destroyed the jivatva of that by appreciation of the nature of atma or brahma. So vinirmalam kritva, afterwards what happens to that vritti, akhandakara vritti? Jnanam svayam nashyet, that vritti itself gets destroyed. That destroyed means it is in a dormant state, it is not available. That's otherwise here he would not have told atma gocharaha vrittayaha anumiyante, means they are there. So means the evidence cognition of that vritti is not there, not there, because to evidently cognize who must be there? Dhyata must be there. The dhyata is not there. So the jnanam svayam nashet, how? Jalam katakarenot, just as the nut powder of a kataka nut, which is olden days used for the purification of the water. The muddy water was purified by this. Now what is used is alum. So in a dirty water, muddy, not dirty means muddy water. Muddy water, you put the alum, what happens? It forms a layer, and the layer makes the all the sediments, makes all the, that means the mud or that means dirt settles below, along with that alum also settles down. Like that, the kathaka nut powder was being sprinkled in this muddy water, and it used to form a layer, thin layer, and it used to settle down. While settling down, all the mud and the dirt used to settle at the bottom. Along with that, even the nut powder also used to settle down. If nut powder doesn't settle down, the pure water or impure water? Mud, see, look, that must have been there. What is that? Dirt must have, might have settled down, but you have added some other impurity as such. No, it also has to settle down. There it is said that akhanda akaravati disappears. Yes, disappears. How? It is not available for the evident cognition, but it is there dormant. Atma gocharaha, because why? Anumiyante. Anumiyante. Afterward they are inferred. Without that samadhi will not be possible. Therefore, smaranad anumiyante. Vithitasya samuthita smaranad anumiyante. See, they are there. That is what the means this. The difference between the sleep and the samadhi is this. In samadhi what is there? Ajnana vritti is there. In the sleep, ajnana vritti is there, and in samadhi, jnana vritti is there. But it may not be directly cognized. It is there, dormant it is there. So this is what the difference between the samadhi and the means for samadhi, what is necessary? Dhyeka gochara vritti, repeated atma gochara vritti must be. And you say, problem is, look here. You are talking of nirvikalpa samadhi. And in the nirvikalpa samadhi, dhyata is there. It is no more nirvikalpa samadhi, it is savikalpa samadhi. Now look, this vritti pravaha of atmaika gochara vritti is required. Now can it be, is it possible to have the continuous flow of the atma gochara vritti or akhandakara vritti without any effort? Now forget for the timing akhandakara vritti or atma gochara vritti. To have any vritti in the mind, what is necessary? Effort is necessary or not? Sure. No, effortlessly vritti comes. We first settle upon that. For vritti, effort is required or not? That is our problem, you know, because we are so much habituated to entertain the vritti, it appears as though to entertain vritti, no effort necessary. To get rid of vritti, great effort is necessary. That is because of our problem of habit. See, look, to think, now let us come here. to think effort is necessary or not to think effort is necessary. Effort is necessary to think or not to think. What is that? No, I could not understand. To think, to think. Okay, because you have heard earlier, that's why. Swamiji had taken that, that's why you are telling that. To think effort is necessary. Not, we being free from the thought is natural condition, but today we are in such a state that the flux of thought is so great that it appears as though to get rid of them we need great effort, because that is what we have landed in. So, to have the vrittis, we should have the perception. Leave aside the memory. So, memory also is based on some perception, earlier perception. So, have the perception. To perception, to perceive what is necessary. Sense organs, we have to make use of the sense organs. We have to make use of the mind. All these are necessary. Is it not? Without effort, vrittis cannot be there. So first I am, then afterwards with the help of the antakarana and the jnanendriyas, I gather the perception and the vrittis come in the mind. After based on that memories, the smarana may be there, that is different thing, vritti may be there. Now, to have the vrittis, we should have the effort. To put forth the effort, the one who puts forth the effort is necessary or not? We must be there. In nirvikalpa samadhi, the dhyata being not there, the one who can possibly put forth the effort being not there, how come the vrittis can come there? Of course, your vritti may be an exclusive vritti. Which vritti? The akhanda akara vritti, atma gochara, that atma gochara, the bhyayika gochara, gocharatva must be there. That may be an exclusive vritti because of which you say as a nirvikalpa samadhi admitted. But that vritti, for that vritti to be there, efforts are necessary. For effort, the dhyata must be there. And in your nirvikalpa samadhi, dhyata is not there. How come this flow, continuous flow of thought, or that means the particular akhandakara vritti or bhyayika gochara vritti, is possible? I think it is not possible. That is what the doubt is. It is not. What you say is correct. Dhyata is not available, and therefore it appears as though such a continuous flow of the dhyayika gocharatva may not be possible. It appears to be so. No, so there is a, that means a, there is a, that means a cause, because of which this pravaha, this continuous flow of the atma gochara vritti, rakhandakara vritti, or the dhyayika gocharatva is possible. How? Vritti na manu vrittistu prayatna prathamadati. अदृष्टा सकृद अभ्यास संस्कार सचिवाद् भवेत्. वृत्ति नाम अनुवृत्ति प्रथमादपि प्रयत्नात् अदृष्टा सकृद अभ्यास संस्कार सचिवाद् भवेत्. अनुवृत्ति मीन्स द कंटिन्यूअस फ्लो. दट इज प्रवाह रूपेण अनुगति ही. अनुवृत्ति मीन्स प्रवाह रूपेण अनुगति, द कंटिन्यूअस फ्लो ऑफ द वृत्ति. विच वृत्ति? नॉट एनी वृत्ति. विच वृत्ति? आत्मगोचर वृत्ति, ध्येयक गोचर वृत्ति, टू द एक्सक्लूजन ऑफ ऑल अदर रेस्ट ऑफ द वृत्ति. वृत्ति नाम परंपरा. परंपरा मीन्स सक्सेशन. वन आफ्टर मीन्स इन ए कंटिन्यूअस फ्लो. प्रवाह रूप प्रवाह रूपेण अनुगति और वृत्ति नाम परंपरा. सक्सेशन ऑफ दिस वृत्ति नाम अनुवृत्ति कंटिन्यूअस फ्लो दिस वृत्ति. इट टेक्स प्लेस लाइक दिस. प्रथमादपि प्रयत्न, बाय द प्रथम प्रयत्न, बाय द इनिशियल एफर्ट. व्हाट इज द इनिशियल एफर्ट? बिफोर एंटरिंग द समाधि, व्हाट वॉज यू डूइंग? निधिध्यासन. लुक, व्हाट वॉज बीइंग डन इज निधिध्यासन. Samadhi you are not doing, or you are not taking to. It just gets rectified that way, as a result of the nididhyasana. So therefore, so prathamadari prayatna. Prathamad means that samadhi purva kalinat prayatna. By the efforts of nididhyasana, before entering into the samadhi. By that means, that prayatna, that effort in the nididhyasana, generates a momentum to continue in the
samadhi. So that is there. The means samskaras are necessary. So that is also that one thing. Again,
adrishta sakrut abhyasa samskara sativad bhavi.
Coupled with that,
earlier momentum is not there, the person will not go to samadhi because it has to, nididhyasana he has to take.
And thereafter,
what is sativalaya? Secretariat.
They have changed it to mantralaya. I think they have made it mantralaya.
Okay, mantralaya means actually it should have been mantralaya, not mantralaya.
Mantralaya, you see, it should have been mantralaya. Alaya, you know, other devices, devalaya, vaidyalaya, granthalaya, like that, it should have been mantralaya. But they have made it mantralaya, some mantra jantar must be going on. They don't rule the country or the state, all such things, only things going on there, maybe. But actually, they are also called as the sativalaya.
Sativaha means secretary.
Sativala means secretary.
Sativad, who is the sativa secretary?
What is the job of a secretary?
To help. Secretary's job is to help, to render the help to the one who is, that means under whom he is working.
Therefore, thou look here.
Sativad. Sativad means, that means from the, that means the help of the aid that is given by these two.
There are two now.
Sativad means actually they are sativau. There are two aids, two helpers are there to have that samadhi continued. What are those? One is adrishta. Adrishta is punya. Adrishta is punya. But what type of punya you have to see here?
Actually, this is a little parlance of the yoga, one of the Patanjali Yoga Sutra.
They call something that is, you come to that specific name. Actually, it is not the punya. Punya, how do you get the punya? By good karma, satkarmas. But a person does satkarmas to reap the harvest of punya. And what for he wants the punya? To have the bhogas, to have the sense enjoyment. So, I am doing something to have certain sense of enjoyment, either here or hereafter in the... At the same time, if the person does something bad, what will happen? The papa also will be punched there. Not only punya, papa also will be there.
Okay.
This is the papa and punya which gives rise to the bhoga, so the sukha or dukkha. But if there is a person who is highly vairagi, he has got perfect vairagya. He has no hankering for any sense object, etc. At the same time, he does Ishwara Aradhana, prayers, etc. Satkarma he does. His punya will not be utilized for the bhoga. Because he has no desires whatsoever. Provided there is no desire. Even if slight trace of desire is there, he will get hooked to the particular sense object. If the desires are not there, and yet he has done such thing, Ishwara Aradhana, etc., certainly he will get the punya. At the same time, he is a mumukshu. Where will the punya be utilized? It will be encashed for Shravana, Manana, Vididhyasana in a sense. To get the opportunities for Shravana, Manana, Vididhyasana. Right type of guru. Right environment. So that means free from obstruction, pratibandhaka, free from all being all these things. So it can get encashed as such. So adrishta here mentioned is, it is called as, in their yogic parlance they say, it is adharma samsrishtaha punya visheshaha. Adharma samsrishtaha punya visheshaha. It is a particular type of punya which is totally asamsrishta. It is not touched by adharma, means papa.
That's what you said.
Means with the punya of such type, where the person has got the high vairagya, he is not at all interested in the sense enjoyment, either here or hereafter. His only goal is to gain the knowledge and get freed from the bondage of samsara.
So there such a thing means a pure punya as it were as such.
They call that, they have got a technical term for that, they say it is what is called as the Ashukla Krishna Karma Khyaha, the Adrishtaha. अशुक्ल कर्ण अशुक्ल कृष्ण कर्माख्या मीन्स इट इज न शुक्ल कृष्ण कर्माख्या मीन्स कर्म फल ऑफ न शुक्ल कृष्ण शुक्ल मीन्स लिटरली राइट कृष्ण इज ब्लैक मीन्स इन द सेंस इट इज बॉर्न ऑफ प्योर सात्विक कर्म नॉट परफॉर्म्ड फॉर द सेक ऑफ गेनिंग द टेंथ एंजॉयमेंट हियर और हियर आफ्टर मीन्स इट इज समथिंग विच इज परफॉर्म्ड बाय a highly matured mumukshu who has not yet got the knowledge. So he has done in the past as such and he has got such a punya to his account. It is not meant for any bhogas anywhere as such. So they say Rishim, they have got a yoga sutra for that. Karma shukla krishna yoginaha trividham itaresham. In the case of a yogi they say karma. Karma here in the sense of karma phala only. Ashukla, that is ashukla krishna. Yoginaha. For the yogis, the karma, the karma phala means that punya is Ashukla Krishna. Ashukla Krishna means it is not meant for any bhoga as such. The person has got high amount of vairagya. Whereas itaresham, for other people, trividham, three types means that karma phala will be ishtam, anishtam and mukha. Think what they categorize as such. So means that here is a person who is least bothered about the bhogas as such. And he has got that much of punya. That capital of punya is necessary. One thing, not just enough. So already prathama prayatna is there. Prathama prayatna means earlier efforts of the continuous, atni or consistent and continuous vididhyasana, that initial momentum is there. It is supplemented by such type of punya vishesha, particular type of punya where the bhoga etc. do not come in picture as well. Then asakrit abhyasa samskara. The samskara, that is the impressions gathered by the asakrit abhyasa. Asakrit means repeated. Sakrit is once, asakrit is repeated. Repeated practice of what? Here repeated practice means, in the sense, abhyasa is of samadhi. Means, he takes to nididhyasana. Nididhyasana leads to samadhi. But he is not going to be there in samadhi for a long time. Again he comes out of that. Again he takes to nididhyasana, leads to samadhi. Again he comes out, again is that, so like that. If samadhi continues without interruption, it is a matter of 18 to 21 days. Okay? Afterward, the body will not survive. Samadhi. We have got if uninterrupted samadhi, not being aware of the body, including the not being aware of the body, including the entire world. That is, if that continues without any break as such, that is 18 to 21 days, depending on the constitution of the person. Maybe a rare exceptional cases like Ramakrishna Paramahansa. 40 days. So he was in the 40 days. Afterwards, he was brought down. That is what it is. What happens? He is taking to. It gets broken. Again, he takes to. That generates the samskara. Abhyasa samskara of the means effort at the level of nididhyasana only. He enters the samadhi, comes out. Again, nididhyasana enters samadhi, means itself is generating a samskara. Abhyasa samskara sachivad means sahakari karanabhyam. These supplementary causes, what are those? The initial momentum of the nididhyasana to go into samadhi, added with the particular type of adrishta, means prarabdha is involved. Adrishta means some prarabdha is involved of that. So that is that. Plus the repeated such taking to the samadhi, by that it takes place. Bhavet. What bhavet? Vritti naam anuvrittihi bhavet. So the continuous flow of the vritti. Which vritti? Vyeka gochara, akhandakara vritti, atma gochara vritti. They may not be manifest directly as such, but they are there dormant. That is what is inferred from the memory that, oho, I was in the state of samadhi. Okay. So bhave. Now, one says, look, who has told like this? Is some that means vruddha sammati. Means some that means, yes, it is so. It has been told by the earlier masters. So, I think you are telling something new to us. One may say that what you are talking is something new to us. It may not be in the Shastras. Has it been said so by earlier great masters? Such a question is possible. He says, yes. Not just great masters, none other than Bhagavan, the Lord Krishna himself has spoken about this in the Gita.
यथादीपो निवातस्थ इत्यादिभिरनेकधा भगवानिममेवार्थमर्जुनाय न्यरूपयत्। यथा दीपः निवातस्थः इत्यादिभिः भगवान् इमम् एव अर्थम् अर्जुनाय अनेकधा न्यरूपयत्।
भगवान अर्जुनाय अनेकधा न्यरूपयत्। लॉर्ड कृष्णा हिमसेल्फ अनेकधा न्यरूपयत् इन मेनी फोल्ड वेज। न्यरूपयत् मीन्स डिस्क्राइब्ड, हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड दिस ओनली। दिस ओनली मीन्स अबाउट दिस समाधि ओनली। यू मे से लॉर्ड कृष्णा हैज नॉट यूज्ड द वर्ड समाधि देयर। नो, इट इज व्हाट ही सेड। यथा दीप, दिस इज व्हाट द क्लू फॉर समाधि।
यथा दीपः निवातस्थः,
यथा दीपो निवातस्थो नेङ्गते सोपमाश्रिता योगिनो यतचित्तस्य सो योगं चित्तस्य युञ्जत युञ्जतो योगमात्मनः। दिस् इस् वाट् इस् सेड् गीता चाप्टर् 6 स्टान्जा 19 स्टान्जा चाप्टर् 6।
यथा दीपः निवातस्थः,
लैक् earlier also he has told, author has given this, 55,
Nivata Deepavat Chittam,
Nivata Deepavat Chittam, Dhyayika Gotram. So, like a flame of a lamp in a breezeless place, how it is steady and continuous. So, that is what he says,
Yata Deepaha Nivatastha, Nivate Sitaha Deepa,
like that, Deepa means lamp, means flame of a lamp. So, just in the place where there is no wind, not even the breezes, sir. So, like that, how steady and continuous it is. So actually that is what is the description of samadhi only. Ityadibhi, by this, because ityadibhi anekada in the sense, manifold ways, because he talked earlier, sityau deshe pratishthapya siramasana matmana, etc., how to sit, etc., all that is to be taken to, he goes on describing, that is from stanza 11 of chapter 6 of Bhagavad Gita. And he continues up to stanza 29, where he concludes, where he says, Sarvabhutastamatmanam sarvabhutani chatmani ikshate yoga yukta atma sarvatra samadarshinaha.
What he appreciates is what? Everything is atma and atma only. From his vision there is nothing other than the atma.
So from stanza 11 to 29, in a manifold ways, Lord Krishna has spoken about this samadhi only. That absorption of the mind in the appreciation of oneself, that is what he has spoken to. Again here also, yesterday I told you, vidhyasana, not that all the time you sit with the closed eyes, 24 hours. It may not be possible. So in the beginning it is necessary. So that means withdraw oneself from the this, but afterwards it must be means whether either closed or either open, the vision is only oneself only. So because how is it possible? When the world is in front of you, how can you have the vision of Brahma? Is it not? When you open the eyes, what happens? Brahma comes in front of your eyes. More often than not, the unwanted neighbor comes, is it not? No. That rooted, that nishtha is such that there is nothing other than Brahma. That is not an earlier stage of Shravana. The one who has so much, that means nishtha, that for him there is nothing other than Brahma. No doubt what is there is now is the perception is there, but Bhajitavi. See, it is Jagat only, but Bhajitatva is there, means negated. Another thing is there. See, look here. Jnani, when he does vyavahara, have you got ahankara? By the back. Have you got ahankara? If ahankara is there, he is not jnani. How can you say? See, look here. You call it jnani. महाराज जी प्लीज आइए, प्लीज प्लीज ओ दैट मींस वेट मास्टर प्लीज कम टू माय हाउस. ही सेड आई विल कम टुमारो, टुडे आई एम वेरी बिजी. ज्ञानी महात्मा, ओके, आई एम वेरी बिजी, टुमारो आई विल कम. व्हेन ही सेड आई विल कम, व्हाट डज ही रिफर एज आई? सच्चिदानंद परमात्मा. सच्चिदानंद परमात्मा कांट गो एनीवेयर, राइट? ही सर्वव्यापी. So does he not refer the body as I? Yes. Is it not ahankara? Achha. If a great master says I, it is not ahankara. And if you and me tell, then what? you label it as ahankara. They say no. If the teacher spells wrongly, it's a slip of the tongue. If you spell wrongly, it is a mistake. Is it not? Is it like that? So, how come? No. That is what is there. That badhita means it appears like ahankara, but it is like a roasted seed. It is like a burnt rope, not capable of binding him any further. Vyavahara, in vyavahara it is a different thing. Therefore, so that being the case, the same thing means with the open eye, the nishtha is so intense that what he sees is nothing from his vision. No doubt it appears as jagat, but nothing but the manifestation of Brahma only. So, but for samadhi, that also he has to get rid of, means he has to get absorbed. So therefore, vididhyasana can be continuous. Vididhyasana can be continuous that way also. So, and what other preoccupation he has got? Prarabdha vashat, if he happens to be the teacher, etc., that he has to be. You know, I read somewhere, but I could not get the authentic source of that. It seems Yajnavalkya, you know Yajnavalkya, celebrated sage. So he remarked, it seems somewhere, just before the taking sannyas, many students whom I have taught, he was a jnani, whom I have taught, they have got totally absorbed in this knowledge. And me, fellow, what am I doing? Running the Gurukula. That's what it is. He was a great master. Not only that, he was a very rich acharya also. You know the Janaka's court, you must have known that episode is there. He was running the Gurukula as such, and I am still continuing in this. Now he said, enough of it. Let me quit and get lost in that. That's what I read it, but I could not get the source of that. This is the authentic. Somewhere it was mentioned, there was no mention of the source. If it is really so, because it mentioned as such, what he meant was that was withdraw from this and get lost there. What he meant is samadhi only. Samadhi as such. I am not sure about the authenticity of the statement. So I didn't get that. Okay. So therefore now, so this is how Lord Krishna himself also has described about that. So therefore I have not spoken anything new from my pocket as such. This is what the samadhi is. Now the secondary result of such a samadhi, samadhi he avantara phalam. Secondary result of that means it gives so much of punya. Anada viha samsare sanchita karma kotayah. Anena vilayam yanti shuddho dharmo vivardhate. इह अनादौ संसारे संचिताः कर्मकूटयः अनेन विलयं यान्ति शुद्धः धर्मः विवर्धते. इह शुद्धः धर्मः विवर्धते. इह अनादौ संसारे, सो दिस इज व्हाट द रिजल्ट. दिस इज द रिजल्ट. व्हाट रिजल्ट? अवांतर. अवांतर मीन्स अ सेकंड रिजल्ट. व्हाट इज द मेन रिजल्ट ऑफ samadhi? You can't say jnana, because without jnana you will not be able to take nididhyasana. Without nididhyasana you will not be able to enter into the samadhi. Means it is a nishtha, we can say. It is absorbed, being absorbed in the knowledge of oneself. That's what. Means it will help to eradicate the deha tadatmya totally. Efforts in the realm of the nididhyasana, but totally eradication of the Dehatadatmya will be with the because of the fructification of the vididhyasa. And what is it? It is nothing but samadhi. And earlier, from this also you can make out that samadhi, the continuity of samadhi depends on adrishta and abhyasa, samskara and prathama prayatna. All that we can do efforts in terms of the prathama prayatna. And that prathama prayatna, repeated prathama prayatna itself will amount to the abhyasa, samskara, provided he enters into samadhi. About adrishta, what can you do? At that time, oh, I think for this, will he take fresh karmas to generate punya so that he can what? Be in samadhi for a longer period of time? It is already gone by, long, long gone. Why can you not take to karma? We are talking about Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana. That means thorough knowledge is there, aparoksha jnana is there, and then he is taking Nididhyasana. At that time, why can he not take to karma? Take to karma, who is necessary? Karta, where is karta? There is no karta. There is no question of taking to fresh karma to get generate some particular type of adrishta so that you can continue in the samadhi. That occasion doesn't arise at all. Therefore, we have to say that prarabdhavasa. Some may be lost somewhere in the samadhi, some may be elsewhere, something that is in the marketplace. So how a jnani will behave, we have no clues at all. I don't know whether you have read somewhere. You see, Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was somewhere just where we were going for a sport. He saw a group of people. They had circled around another person. He just was peeping in there, what is happening there. What he saw there, which for the outward look as apparently a mad person as it were, was having some roti in the hand, sitting on a dog, eating himself and feeding the dog. And all these fellows are making fun of that person. Of this person who was doing like this. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was looking there as well. He waited for a while. Then, that person who was supposed to be a mad person, he said, Vishnu parisito Vishnuhu Vishnuhu khadayati Vishnave katham hasatire Vishnu sarvam Vishnumayam jagat. Vishnu is sitting on Vishnu. Vishnu eats and Vishnu feeds Vishnu. Oh you Vishnu, why are you laughing? All other fellows thought this another bout of madness. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa understood. He just went. We don't know how he behaved. That is not a license for hypocrisy. Huh? I am a jnani and therefore what? I can behave as I like. We don't know. It is all it is that the prarabdha vashat, whatever it may be. Okay. Now he says, look. Avantara phala here is iha samsare in this world. And what type of samsara it is? Anadau iha samsare. The samsara which is anadi. Why the samsara is anadi? When did samsara begin? I begin with this. Look, before this kalpa started, was the kalpa there? Yeah, kalpa was there. Dissolution, Brahmaji was sleeping. Other day was sleeping, kalpa. When Brahmaji was sleeping, was there a creation there? And why did the creation came? Because of the karma phala. So therefore, karma phala sada jivas. So therefore, the creation started, is it not? When Brahmaji woke up, the creation started. Is there no beginning? Why the creation was there? Because of the karma phalas of the jivas. Where did they gather? In the previous kalpa. We may draw a beginning line. Oh, the kalpa started from here. But that kalpa is based on earlier kalpa. And that earlier kalpa is based on earlier kalpa. Earlier kalpa on earlier kalpa. There is no beginning at all. Because why? Ignorance is beginning this. Samsara is because of avidya. Avidya is beginning this. Avidya is beginning this. All kalpas are beginning this. There is no beginning at all. So therefore, but for vyavahara, we may start the starting point as such. Oh, from this kalpa. It is just for the sake of vyavahara. But there if you probe, itself, that creation is because of the karma phalas. Where the creation, karma phalas, because jivas were not there to there. They were in the earlier kalpa, it goes on like that. So, anadav yaha samsare, sanchitaha karma kotayaha. Sanchita karmas. How many karmas? Karma kotayaha. Karma kotayaha, karmanam kotayaha. Means endless karmas. Both papa and punya. These are there. Because jiva is anadi. Anadi jiva in the anadi samsara has done endless karmas as such, and all those karma phalas are there. So karma kotayaha sanchitaha. What happens to them? Anena vilayam yanti. Anena samadhina, the masculine. Samadhi masculine. Anena samadhina. Otherwise it would have been anaya. Okay. Anena samadhina. So that by this samadhi, vilayam yanti. They get totally. Anena means by this samadhi. Means his nishtha is so far all good. That is what is told, that jnana agni sarva karmani bhasma sat. The fire of knowledge destroys all the karma. Siyante chasya karmani tasmin drishti paravar. Achya karmani. All karmas. So, in the wake of knowledge of this, they get destroyed. That means prarabdha is except means agami and sanchita are gone. And prarabdha is there we say, Shruti says, by courtesy with respect to vyavahara. Respect vyavahara, because this guy is there in the world, and ups and downs in his life we see. We have to find out a cause. Some prarabdha is there. Suppose he is lost in samadhi, from his standpoint prarabdha is there. He is not aware of the body, he is not aware of the world as well. But when he is aware of it, we can say whatever that he does, it's some prarabdha is there. By courtesy we say that prarabdha is there. So, anena vilayam yanti. So therefore, they get destroyed. Shuddho dharmo vivardhate. That means this gives rise to Shuddha dharma. Shuddha dharma here is the dharma which is necessary. Dharma means punya. The punya which is necessary to destroy avidya and gain the moksha. Or it can be taken like this. Shuddha dharma means savilasa avidya nivartaka. Sakshatkara sadhana bhutaha dharmaha. The punya, which has got the capacity to destroy, see, so that means avidya. It has got capacity to destroy avidya, not just like that, along with savilasa. What is vilasa? Savilasa here is, along with the vilasa, karyavarga, ramification in terms of samsara, along with the product of samsara, that punya which is capable of destroying the ignorance. Avidya nivartaka means sakshatkara sadhana bhutaha, which is the means for sakshatkara. How the punya by itself will not give you this? This is possibly what was told as the adrishta samskara sativa. So means it is that of a mumukshu of the karmas which are taken to. That means for the sake of liberation, not for any bhoga as such. So that type of Shuddhaha, Dharmaha, or it can be taken as Avidyanashaka Moksha Sadhana Bhutaha Dharmaha. A punya which can destroy the avidya. Again, Avidyanasha means Shravana Manana Nididhyasana comes there. So, but some capital is necessary to have that opportunity. So Moksha Sadhana Bhutaha, so that type of Shuddhaha, which means for Moksha, for that type of Vivardhati. It grows means it's such a samadhi showers there. Where one doubt is possible. How do you say this samadhi? Look here, we are talking of what samadhi? This is not the Patanjali samadhi. Yogastu chitta vritti nirodha, we are not talking of that. That is the andha samadhi or jada samadhi. Actually, if Patanjali yogi has got right attitude of Shraddha, and he takes to Shravan, etc., he is in a better position to win this. Because if he has got that Yogasu Chitta Vritti Nirodha, that Samadhi he has got, already he has got the ready frame of the mind. All that is lacking is Shraddha, right Shraddha, Shraddha and the proper inquiry. If he has got right attitude and he takes to this inquiry, Shravana means inquiry, This is a better position to enter into this, what is called Jnana, Jnana Samadhi. Okay, that is a different thing. Good. As a Patanjali Yoga, as it is accepted as a technique by Buddha. But when you philosophize as that means as something, then the problem starts. So that alone, where the knowledge is not there, and you see Samadhi, when he gets up from that, away from the Uttana, Vitthana takes place, where is the eye? His eye is centered. Body. But he will take the body as I because Jnana is not there. But certainly he has that absorbed state of mind even when I am experiencing such a statement of mind, that vikalpa also was not there. It was virikalpa from that standpoint, but not from the standpoint of the Jnana. The question arises here. How do you say this knowledge can destroy all the karma? What we